Hey guys, this is David Kwan, here to talk more about Deus Ex and how I kind of played through the game. I tried to be as stealthy as possible, but it's not easy in this game. I think the beginning part was, you know, you start off in Liberty Island, and Liberty Island is a really great demonstration of the vibe of this game. It's, you get to explore this large area, and it's such a large area that you know, the enemies don't see you until you get really close to them, so you just kind of wait. You see their patrol patterns, and you crouch, and you walk behind them, and then whack with the crowbar to get a stealth kill. Or with the baton, or the stun rod. Stun rod, I think, is really interesting. I think it's a great concept that they limited the ammo capacity, so you would always have to be scrounging around for more ammo. I think the beginning levels of this game really is all about scrounging for ammo and scrounging for lockpicks. Lockpicks and hack tools are so easy to use up and to spend, but so rare to find. So I think that those are the biggest rewards of any exploration. And it feels weird that, like, for the first, maybe even more than half the game, or even maybe even more than first half the game, you're not rewarded with skill points all that much. It really is after, what is it after? It's like after a certain level, I think it's like after the missile silo level, or maybe a little before that. Probably a little before that, like a little after Hong Kong, that you finally start getting, after the catacombs, that's right. It's in the catacombs in Paris that you really just, everything you do, you get skill points. You get skill points left and right for doing whatever, right as you get to the catacombs in Paris. And I feel like that's how the entire game should have been. Because it really is awesome to get skill points and use up, but I mean, that maybe that would have made the game too easy. I don't know, but with the mechanics of the game being the way it is, I feel like that would have been really helpful. But in the beginning of the game, you really have to be careful how you spend your skill points. I started the game focusing more on hacking and computer skills, because I play the game as stealthily as I can, and I would save the game multiple times, and usually things don't work out, and then I would just load back the save. Because the combat in this game is so weird, you know, with if your weapon skills are not up to snuff, it takes time for your... It's kind of like Mass Effect 1, maybe that's the comparison I want to make when you're doing the gunplay. You have to hold the cursor, your aim cursor over the enemy for a certain amount of time for the aim cursor to get narrowed down, and you have a much better accuracy. But if the enemy is moving around, this is really hard to do. When you just start firing, gunplay is you know, intentionally that way, so that you focus more on improving your skills and improving your weapons. I do feel like improving weapons makes much more of a difference than improving your skills. In terms of weapon ability, or weapon, in terms of getting better at using the weapons. Because once I upgraded the sniper rifle with accuracy mods, and with recoil mods, and the silencer mod, and the damage mods, that thing is incredible. I'm just like way far off in the distance, I aim at someone, and the cursor is like this precise. You know, it's like this precise. I get it over to the head of an enemy, and I'm so far away that even though we are looking right at each other, the enemy doesn't know that I'm sniping him. One shot, boom, dead. Really awesome. So upgrading weapons eventually becomes really important. Exploration, I think, is really important for three different things. For lockpicks, hack tools, and weapon mods. Those are really the biggest rewards for exploration. Everything else is kind of like, okay, more ammo, biocell. Don't really need biocell that much, because you'll encounter those repair robots from time to time. Not frequent enough, but you know, you can get by. The medibots are pretty rare, so medkits is extremely important. But once you get that, once I got that augmentation ability to regenerate my health, became much easier, although that really uses up the augmentation meter thing. So it's really a great amount of strategy. I really just mostly just use kind of stealthy pathways. It's funny because once I figured out one way to end up somewhere, I'll kind of backtrack and try to see what the other routes to get through with this would be. So sometimes I would spend a lot of time on one level just exploring every which way. That's probably the fun part about Deus Ex and just exploring everywhere, trying to talk to as many people as possible, trying to do as many of these other optional quests that is as possible. It's one of the things that is really tiresome about Deus Ex is finding passwords and, you know, passwords and key numbers that you kept to input into the doors and stuff. You don't necessarily have to hack to get anywhere. You could just find these data cubes that has the information that you need, like username and password for a computer. But you kind of have to... It's not like a modern game where if you get to a door that you need to type into codes. Modern games would be like there would something would pop up that shows you that key number. No, you have to go back to the interface, go to your notes or goal sections, and try to find that number. If you picked it off of a book, you know, endgame book, you actually have to write that down inside the notes of the interface. Pretty tedious. It's not a modern game. This is 2013. I actually had pen and paper ready, and I wrote some stuff down, because I needed that information to progress further on. Not to progress, but to get to this exploratory area. So that's pretty interesting. There's a lot of backtracking on some of the levels. I think this game really, really liked the Unaco levels, the Unaco base inside Liberty Island. You have to go through that three times. You have to go through Hell's Kitchen in New York City four times. The game seems to really love those areas, and those areas are fun every time. I don't know. Hell's Kitchen kind of got really tiresome the fourth time or the third time around, because it's a very crowded level, and especially the last time you visit Hell's Kitchen, it is just crowded with enemies. And I remember when you have to escape Hell's Kitchen after you meet up with your brother Paul Denton, and you have a choice of either trying to rescue him or just leaving him to death. I tried to rescue him, but he still ended up dying, so that sucked. But I used up a grenade and I killed a lot of people, so that was cool. But you have to escape Hell's Kitchen, and then you get a notice from your pilots, just like, JC, there's a lot of enemies coming to your area. I'm just like, okay. I hit save. All of a sudden, there really is a group of enemies that are in the area. It was ridiculous. I had to wipe out a lot of people in that part. The navigation, trying to navigate through areas, is also something that you really have to get used to. You kind of have to keep a good mental imagery of where to go, how to get there. This game does not hold your hand, which is one of the great things about it, but it also can be kind of tiresome and tedious at certain times. So definitely there's that. The later parts of the game get pretty crazy. There are some enemies that are just insane. Those enhanced guards is probably my least favorite, because once you're discovered, if you're a good distance away from them, they start firing rockets. And it's not like two rockets at a time. And then 2 second wait time, shoo shoo, two rockets at a time. Each rocket, if it hits you, instant death, no matter how much health you have. So I really hated those enemies. But then I got that laser sword, high frequency sword, and keep that sword once you get it. It's amazing. And I increased my melee ability skill, and I would just sneak up behind them and whack! Yes! So satisfying killing them that way. So satisfying. But I think the last two levels is where it gets pretty crazy. Last two levels being, the last three levels. They're really fun. I think the game really picks up its action and intensity the last few parts. The San Francisco level was really interesting, how I could kind of jump up to the top of the building and jump up and sneak my way there. And I would have to be really careful that I don't get discovered, because once I do, the scientist's daughter gets killed. And that's, I really like the fact that even if you fail a mission, you know, there's no game over because you failed a mission. The story continues on. So that's really cool. The only time a mission is failed and the game is over is when, you know, your character that you're playing as, JC Denton, dies. I think that is pretty revolutionary for his time, that concept, that your game continues even if you fail a mission. Really awesome. But yeah, that California Valley level, I dropped down, became quiet, and then I threw a grenade in the corner. Boom! Everyone just died, including the Man in Black agent. And then I dropped down and rescued the daughter. So that was interesting. And then the Area 51 level was a lot of fun. I think my favorite, one of the most fun I had was the ship level, where you go inside the ship and you have to place grenades in certain parts of the ship to make it explode. That was an incredibly fun level, just getting up to the ship and just exploring around, and there's a lot of vents to explore around. There's a lot of secret areas in that ship. That was really awesome. Just exploratory nature of it, and just seeing like how far you can upgrade your characters and seeing using those skills is really cool. I really like this game since because of those nature, and really the way I played it was to be as stealthy as possible, but a lot of times that doesn't happen. It's stealth is kind of hard in this game. So by the later parts of the game, I really enjoyed the game because I had firepower to use when stealth got super difficult. I had the sniper rifle and the assault rifle to make it happen. But combat is not easy in this game. The enemy AI has really great accuracy, but the gunplay is really unwieldy at times. So combat is really difficult, but it can be pretty rewarding once you start becoming super powerful and you hit that augmentation for regenerating health. So those are really my thoughts on kind of how I played through the game. I know I rambled on without much of a focus about this game, but there's definitely a lot to talk about with Deus Ex. It's a classic. I'm glad I was finally able to play through all the levels of the game, because there's, you know, it's they don't make games like these anymore. I keep saying that, but it feels so true. It feels so true, even though I would not be revisiting this game anytime soon, simply because playing this in 2013 was, in a way, very tedious affair because of the fact that it hasn't aged well. But I do recognize that it's a really great game. I do want to make one last video about this game, and in the next video I will talk about the ending and kind of spoil the ending for you guys, or if you haven't already played it, and just kind of go about that, because I think this is one of those endings where it has three different choices that you could make for an ending. That a lot of other games in the future kind of started imitating. Mass Effect 3 is pretty much a ripoff of the ending of Deus Ex, and I'll talk about that in the next video.